Hi everyone, I just wanted to give you an update on how my son is doing. He has improved, continued to improve since my last video update. I'm trying to remember what was going on at the time I did the last update. I know that he was put on steroids to lower his heart rate a few months following my last few videos. I know that my son's heart rate was up, it was 190 beats a minute. He was having fevers, and last week his blood pressure was out of control, but glory to God, they were able to lower his steroids, and they were able to try a new blood pressure medication that seemed to do the trick. So his blood pressure is now more under control. He did have some breathing issues, which started, I think, Friday, either Thursday or Friday, but that seems to have gotten better. He continues to get breathing treatments and so forth. Today we had some issues with pain, like in the abdomen area, like on here. And his skin all over is very tender to the touch. But they did an ultrasound this morning because they were concerned about his liver is slightly enlarged, and they're concerned that maybe the tenderness in the liver meant there might have been some changes in his liver. But praise God, I found out tonight, I got a report tonight from the doctor, that his liver is fine, so it's functioning okay. We just now have to, I guess we're just waiting to see, like, make sure that his heart rate gets back to where it should be. It's still in the, it's in the 140s now. I have gone down to the 118. Well, I sat at 118, 119. But we're back in the 140s, which it seems to be even. It's not going higher than that. It's not going lower, but it's not going higher either. He hasn't had any more fevers lately. Blood pressure's been under control. And his white blood cell counts are 11. I don't know if I recorded that the last video that I did, but 4 to 11 is the normal range. So these all just may be aches and pains he's having. He's having some itching. His eyes are really, really itchy. His liver is enlarged, and his eyes are yellow, which represents that he is jaundiced and that there is something going on with his liver. His bilirubin level, which indicates... I don't want to say it wrong. I've researched it, and I've asked questions about it, but I'm tired. I can't think of right now the explanation. But bilirubin, the bilirubin measures, I believe, I don't want to say it wrong, but something to do with the liver, the levels that are, has something to do with the liver. And if the levels are high, that indicates that maybe there's some issues going on with the liver. That's what I'm trying to say. Forgive me for stumbling over my words, but that's what the cases with that. So everything is just kind of a watch, wait and see. I'm grateful to God for where we are, especially after having been where we've been. It's very tiring. If I could admonish you to, if you have children, to hold them tight, hold them close to you. If they're healthy, cherish it, appreciate it, thank God for it. If they ask you to go to the park, please don't tell them that right now. I'm busy. I'm on the computer, or I'm doing this phone call. I mean, I'm on a phone call, or I'm watching this TV program. Take the time to turn it off and go outside with them and do something with them. If they want to go to the park, or they want to go play, or they want to go get an ice cream cone, or if they just want to talk to you. And I'm finding out, like when I left my ex-husband, I bought my kids a lot of toys, a lot of things, and I was kind of broke buying them things. But what I realized is what they didn't need, they didn't need things, they wanted me. And they just wanted, they were missing the love of one parent, so they wanted the one parent that they had, and that was me. And I was trying to go to school at the time, I was trying to work on my master's degree about a year ago. It was a little over a year ago now. I should have been finished last August, but my son got ill, and so that took a back seat to my son's health, of course. But I feel bad because there were times where I would be on the computer doing my homework or studying, you know, for tests and things. It was online, I was doing a program online. But still, they wanted my son especially was asking me last June, a year ago, he asked me, Mommy, can we go to the park? Can we go to the park? Okay, let me just finish this paper, let me do this assignment, or and now I wish I put the darn computer down and just gone and taken him apart. Because little things like that, you don't realize when they're gone how much they become big things. Just seeing the child run again and be healthy and happy again is something I long for on a daily basis. And I know it's coming. It's a process. I realize that. But it still hurts. And I was at the store earlier today, and I heard these little girls their mom was with, and they were in a video DVD section. I was looking for a DVD for my son. Their mom said, okay, come on, girls. They were by actually the toy section. That's close to the DVD sections at Target. And this one came on. They were so happy, and they took off running. I could hear them running. They had little sandals on. I could hear the padding of their feet on the ground. I thought about how when I used to be able to take my kids together, we'd go to the store, or we'd go pick out a toy or something, or a DVD, and we'd go do something fun. We always, like, our Saturdays were our days to go spend time together as a little family. I'd take them to story time. We'd do arts and crafts during story time. If we missed it, we would stay at the library and just read books, and they had a little play room. They'd play with the toys. And then if it was during summer, we would go and get wet. They had this water fountain. We'd let the kids just go get wet and have fun. We'd window shop and then maybe get something to eat, and we'd just call it a day. We'd have a lot of fun, and I missed those days so bad. So hug your children, hug your relatives, because you never know when a storm is going to come and literally turn your life upside down. When Paul, the Apostle Paul, was riding on that ship, you know, the storm came and it broke the boat apart, and it said that they survived. The boat was in pieces, but they came in on basically in broken pieces. And right now I feel like my son and my daughters and I are riding on broken pieces. The boat has been broken apart, but we're all still here and we're riding on broken pieces. There's a family who lost their son yesterday at 24 years of age, totally sucked all the life out of me because I grieved with them throughout the day as I was discovering more that their son was not, he was taken off of the machine against the respirator, and that I found that he had a heart attack earlier in the day and he wasn't going to make it. And so when he finally passed, I held his mother in my arms. She cried, and I felt her pain was tremendous, and it sucked the life out of me, and I wasn't right the rest of all day and last night until the Lord sent a lady to minister to me. She knew I was hurting about the family. She tried to minister to the family as well. I told her I was hurting, so she knew that much, but she knew nothing else of my thoughts that day, and God Almighty sent her to me to minister to me. My daughters came, my sister and my mom. I got to see them. I got to hold my baby girls because I missed them. And this lady ministered to me, and the word was that going through the storm is necessary. It is a process. It has to hurt because I have to be able to minister to someone else that's in my shoes, and they have to know that they can make it. And it hurts, but if this is what God wants and I have to go through this, this is my cross to bear, then I'm going to bear this cross. And I just want you to pray for us, because if you're a mom, or a parent at all, I hate to say it just if you're a mom, but you know the pain of to even see your child have a cut or a scrape, it hurts your heart, So if you could just imagine where we are, and I'm not asking for sympathy, I'm just asking for prayers, for strength and endurance, and then at God's time, that my son will be out here and we'll be back to normal. Our lives will be back to normal. Not normal. Normal's not going to be perfect, but out of the hospital, living a regular life and doing ministry. I guess I am doing ministry here, but just, I hope you guys know what I'm trying to say. God bless you. I had no intention of doing an 8-minute something long video, but here we go. So thank you for taking the time to watch and to pray for us and to be a support for my family and I. God bless you all, and I wish you peace and the happiness and joy of the Lord. I pray that you choose Christ if you don't know him today. God bless you, and take care. Bye.